you guys see him?
Shall we begin?
Yeah, let's
yes.
begin. All right, so thank you so much, Stanley, for joining us. It's a pleasure to see you again after 20 years. And I wanted to go back to the year 2000, 2001. We just talked about this was the year of Crouching Tiger, Hidden Dragon, E.E., all of these kind of landmark films in Chinese language cinema. Also, 3-4 years after the handover, what was your state of mind, your creative situation at that time? And where kind of were you as a film director at the time this project appeared?
我哋唔喜歡嘅，因為個作者好大程度係用一個偷窺嘅角度咧去睇兩個男人嘅性愛同埋情色場面居多。咁我就話，如果你唔俾我改編有空間改編咧，我哋就唔拍啦。咁結果製片人答應咗，我哋就保留咗兩個人物同埋一個故仔係發生喺八十年代中。 八十年代中到末期嘅一個故仔，嗰樣嗰七八年間、十年間嘅故仔，因為嗰個時代背景對特別對陳漢東一個官二代嘅角色係好有幫助嘅，即係我覺得理應有好多嗰陣時嘅時代氛圍嗰啲嘢可以展現喺陳漢東呢個角色身上嘅。 咁係咯，所以係南語係有個好大程度嘅改編嚟嘅，佢其實已改到已經唔似個原著小説㗎啦。咁因為我96年咧，因為拍嗰個英國電影協會有關電影100周年，我負責拍中國電影100周年嗰個紀錄片叫《男生女相》。 咁嗰個某個程度係我一個come out嘅作品嚟嘅，所以到咗2000年，我覺得自己作為一個同志，去選擇自己作品嘅時候，要拍啲咩嘅時候咧，我係唔能夠，我提醒自己唔能夠用去消費呢個 issue 嘅呢個 議題嘅同志議題嘅。
Thank you. I'm wondering if we could talk a little bit about the casting of the film. Han Dong and Lan Yu, played by Hu Jun and Liu Ye, are two really just incredibly fully formed characters. Dare I say, two of the more memorable characters to appear in Chinese cinema during this period. And it also helped launch, really kind of recreate the careers of these two actors who launched them into the superstar realm after making this film. Could you talk about how you cast these actors and what your approach was to working with them on set?
当我做 casting 的时候，胡军其实已经，已经是颇有知名度的演员，颇有名的演员。他参演电视剧，如果大家有看过张元导演的一个也是同志的独立电影叫《东宫西宫》，他也是演一个同志的角色。好，那还有就是他除了 影视电影电视以外，他参加很多，国家话剧团的表演，碰到非常好的导演，比如说像林兆华、孟京辉啊等等很有名的，导演作品也很好，所以他其实那个时候虽然身处在中国大陆，但是他在意识上，在理解角色，理解一个，剧本的。 是很能理解的。那刘烨是刚刚毕业，但是刘烨其实在还没毕业的时候已经拍过一个电影叫《那三那人那狗》，那个电影还在东京电影节拿了大奖。那有趣的是，当我选择他们两个，他们放在一起的 chemistry 是非常好，然后他们两个都是中央戏剧学院毕业的。 胡军整整 比刘烨大了10年，所以他们看完剧本以后接受了这个角色，他们两个都是大直男，但是在整个帮忙了解那个同志，当然我们有做很多资料 research 提供给他们看，但是更多的我觉得在两个角色的互动上面，吴君有点作为大师哥，因为他早10年比刘烨在中央戏剧学院毕业，所以帮了很多很多忙，也很 tender 很照顾这个小师弟，所以某个程度不是一个没有 bonding 那种感觉，绝对有帮助到陈汉东跟蓝宇这个角色的诠释演出。
And so my next question deals with two of the taboos in the film. One, of course, is the on-screen portrayal of homosexuality, and the other is June 4th. And at least in the realm of Chinese language cinema, those are extremely challenging topics to present on screen. And I'm wondering if you could talk about, at this time, 2001, the challenges of putting those two topics together, and what kind of challenges you faced encountering this film.
这个说实在话也是我跟编剧坚持的一点，80年代比如说很多关岛啊反贪腐啊64那个当然也发生在89嘛，对吧，所以我们回避不了的，特别外在的世界所发生的事情怎么影响到陈汉东跟蓝宇的关系，我觉得这个都是一个我们没办法躲避的东西，我们只能够去面对它。那64当然我觉得也就是点到而已，因为某个程度外面发生那么大的事情，但是对我来讲反而64那天的晚上是陈汉东跟蓝宇这个角色的某个程度，我觉得它是一个 commitment 的时间。好，就两个认清楚他们应该走在一起等等。但至于陈汉东接着后来发生公司几乎要倒闭，那个也正是在中国80年代末那个反贪污啊等等那个官场上的一些细节，我觉得这个细节是很帮到那个剧本的。我觉得其实那个时候观众因为比如说64的点到机制或者那些官场，我觉得都没有把那个事情太放大，那个剧情太放大，所以观众透过电影所看到的还是他们只感觉到外面世界的混乱，但是他们更这个电影更让他们走进蓝宇跟陈安东的感情世界。
I'm wondering if we could maybe shine the light on one of your collaborators, and that's William Zhang or Zhang Shuping, who you've worked with many times over the years. He is also a longtime collaborator of Wong Kar-wai. He was both the art designer and the editor for this film. And he's somebody that you don't really hear talked about a lot, but his imprint, I think, is extremely powerful on this film. And I'm wondering if you could talk about what William Zhang brought to this project.
This film is not my first time with Zhang Shuping. Actually, my second film, Zhang Shuping, Love and to Wait, is Zhang Shuping.帮我做的 production designer， 那私底下我们是非常好的朋友。那我觉得，我觉得现在，比如说张树平有开始帮忙一些香港的年轻导演，比如说 Norris Wong， 京都，还有好几位年轻导演的作品剪接，这些电影。这些作品啊，预算都非常有限，所以张树平完全是可以说是收个一个 red pocket 一个红包，就帮这些年轻导演的负责剪接、负责监督一些东西。那我觉得他现在 整个人 very open to the 跟我们朋友啊吃饭聊天啊，他都比以前放松了一点。以前他是一个蛮害羞啊，蛮收藏自己的人，现在不是了。
Maybe we can talk about the visuality in the film. There's a lot of use of mirrors. There's some really interesting shots early in the film when we first meet the two main characters. We have this kind of black and white freeze frame for just a split second of both of the main characters as they're introduced. There's almost jump cut like editing during certain crucial moments of like the June 4th commitment scene. There's some interesting editing there. There's also when Chun Han-dong puts the scarf on Lan Yu, there's some interesting quick editing that takes place. Just wondering if you could talk a little bit about the overall visual strategy of the film and how you came to that strategy and developed it.
这个肯定不是在拍的时候已经预设的，包括你说那个黑白镜头一下子，比如说陈汉东出现的第一个在桌球室，那个是黑白的，然后到蓝宇的出场也是一个黑白的特写，啊，要是蓝宇这个特别我要提一提蓝宇这个黑白的特写，是蓝宇的出场。然后上一个镜头正正是陈汉东回头问他的伙伴工作伙伴，哎，他叫什么名字？那个他的工作伙伴就跟他说蓝宇。声音跟画面这样的结合，就是张淑萍在剪接上给了一个很好蓝宇的出场 entrance。另外静止那个，我觉得我拍的电影，我一直相信电影。或者电影里面的人物啊，常常是游走在虚实中间。好，那这个虚实中间的那个很有意思。我觉得镜子是正正好呈现虚实一个非常有效果的东西。所以我比如说《胭脂扣》里面啊，前面《地下情》啊等等，都很多时候运用镜子。张淑萍跟我开玩笑说他说我要是给你一个景没有镜子的话，搞不好你不会拍了。因为跟张淑萍的合作已经有一定的默契，所以很多时候我都会拍很多，比如说 principal shooting 完了以后，我会跟摄影师去抓一些空镜头啊。举个特别有力量的例子，就是大家刚刚看完电影，记得应该还记得最后陈汉东开着车走在北京的大路，在天桥底工地，一堆篮板在他眼前划过，啊，那个是一个我从饭店每天去一个 location， 那个有跑了两三天，我就觉得这个篮板很有意思，但我不知道那个时候该怎么用的，结果就先拍了，看放在那边做空镜头 empty shot， 看淑萍能不能用得上。结果他看到以后，他就跟他的助理说：“哎，这个好保留下来。”结果他就放到最后，而且这个最后的篮板。很多观众朋友啊，我包括我身边的朋友，我自己有些时候联想起来这个篮板的运用做结尾结束这个电影的那个 moment 是很有意思，而且是非常有力量的。
Okay, and maybe we'll open up for some questions. Any questions you would like to ask the director?
So hi, Dr. Kwan. So I've watched the documentary called Annyeong before, and in that documentary, there are a lot of like directors from like mainland China and from Hong Kong, from Taiwan. They talked about like gender study and talked about homosexual and in the documentary. And during that time, there are a lot of like homosexual films in like Chinese language cinema. But however, like nowadays,like in mainland China, like the kind of types of film to become like more and more like restricted by the policies. We can only see like more and more like homosexual films in like Hong Kong or Taiwan or other places. How do you think like this kind of like backwards?
我是觉得的确在中国大陆要真的就是你说要得到政府的资源来拍这个同志议题，我相信难度很高。 因为很多意识形态上面的东西是抓得蛮紧张的。那香港其实我觉得也离不开，因为香港现在很多审查，包括很多年轻导演得到的钱来拍他们的电影都是一些政府的资源，所以政府对选材 对审片审查的那影响力是有存在的，我相信在台湾比较宽松对待同志议题，但是我觉得很多时候我看到的很开心的就是，我觉得很多年轻导演面对这个议题的时候，不光是 去看同志的身体，更多的是在面对这个 gender 的时候，他们面对包括家庭、包括社会、包括他自己本身种种的找到自己 identity 那个东西是很有意思的，而且情感上也非常的饱满充足。 这点是我看到很多年轻导演，因为跑了一些国际电影节，做评审嘛，看到我都觉得特别开心。
I want to first thank you, Director Kwan, for making this film. I've watched Lan Yu probably no less than 10 times, and this is the first time I've watching it on the big screen, so it's really important to me as well. And my question is related to the kind of aesthetic aspect of the time frame of the film and the transition between, you know, a period of time to another, because the film is a covering of really long time of their relationship from, you know, when Lan Yu was just starting in college, and then later he became like a, you know, working professional, and he died around when he was like 28 or 29. So that's like around 10 years of time frame. And I just really like the transition of time from one period of their relationship to another, and that transition is really subtle, I think. And I just wonder if you can speak on that, because I'm specifically thinking about the scene when they just got back together after Chen Handong's divorce, and that transition of time from, because they meet back around like autumn, but then the next shot you see the outside and it's already winter. So those kind of transition in the film is everywhere, and I think is amazing, but I just wonder if you can speak more on that. Thank you.
其实这个时间的设定，你比如说有透过他们对话的，比如说他们第一次交欢以后，在雪夜，在行人天桥，那个他们提到那1000块钱。 还有电话号码，那个时候蓝宇就说4个月了，整整昨天是4个月了，那其实既呈现了时间，但是也呈现了蓝宇这个孩子对陈汉东有特别的好感，他会把前一天是4个月这个呈现的。 呈现出来他惦念着那天的相处。第二个就是包括中国的年夜饭，你看到他们有 say Happy New Year 新年快乐，有带蓝宇回家吃那个团年饭，这个当然我觉得一方面是要交代时间，另外一方面也是呈现了陈汉东 父亲住院了，他是家里面男性主导地位的那个，他妹妹都说，这不是男女不平等吗？为什么他哥哥也坐着，为什么要我去拿那个斗彩杯啊？这个东西也就是到头来家里认 家里人，他妹妹妹夫当然知道，啊，他妈妈搞不好也心里明白，蓝宇带，陈汉东带朋友的弟弟蓝宇回来，其实你说他既这种用金钱去买卖女体跟男体这个东西，其实家里人都心里明白，所以那场戏剧张载着时间的交代，哦，过中国年了，但是同时也交代了另外一幅家庭图画。另外一个就是在我觉得有些时候我们不用那种 caption 这个是1980年几月几号，我们不讲。当然六四那天是个明确1989年的六四，那天我刚才已经说了，某个程度对我来讲是他们一个 commit 的一天。但是后来比如说陈汉东跟蓝宇说的，哎，我告诉你啊，哈，认识久了熟了就不好玩了，是该散的时候了。这个虽然没有明讲，所谓熟了，时间长了，熟了，认识久了，这个虽然没有说到底是3年还是5年，但是它同样具备了一个时间的流逝的意义。所以到最后这段话，蓝宇把他在收拾那个东西行李准备离开的时候，他重复跟陈汉东说了这个话，然后提醒自己少喜欢他多一点，这个都是跟时间有着很巧妙的联系，这是魏超安在剧本上非常非常独到、非常有意思的描写。
Thank you, 导演。The first thing I want to say is I'm also a big fan of this film, and it's been almost 10 years since the first time I watched it, and tonight was like totally refreshment. I love it so much. And my question is about, it's like a follow-up question about the ending shot, the blue board. And you mentioned you and the DP were catch it for like B-rolls. And for me, every time I watch this film, I think the ending is not only the thing make the ending so powerful, is not only because of frame or, you know, but most importantly is the length. So my question is about, do you know, like, when you grab that B-roll, you know what the length you want. And I'm wondering, like, because it's like, it's not like a natural B-roll for, it's not like a natural length for a B-roll. So for the post-production, did you like repeat it or something like that? And another question related to this is, was that your decision or William Jung's decision to, you know, to extend or to make that decision for the ending? Oh, and also, I'd like to know what's the original ending be like in the script. Thank you.
Mm-hmm. 剧本的 ending 是陈汉东在一个卡拉 OK 跟朋友喝酒聊天，其中有一个小男生就像蓝宇以前一样，就点歌唱你怎么舍得我难过。好，这是原剧本的 ending， 也是一个很有意思的 ending 哈，我觉得，取代这个 ending 而用了蓝板，这个是张淑萍在剪接上的决定。所以后来他决定用这个蓝板的时候，我还回北京补拍了2天，包括陈汉东停车在那工地前。那个 VO 啊说，我一直觉得你没走，你一直在我身边等等，这个都是后来补拍的，因为我们决定已经要用那个蓝板做结束了。至于那个蓝板，其实我们那个时候还是用35的机器用胶片拍的，所以我们蓝板的部分，我们有 用两个 fixed length 哈，但是一个大家有注意到，有些篮板你是透过那个篮板看到背后的一些景观，比如说一些房子啊，你后面的交通啊，那个时候我们 focus 是摆在后面的，但也有部分我们用一个 tighter lens 就 focus 就放在前面的篮板，让后面的背景也虚掉。所以其实张淑萍在剪接的时候是非常有力量的运用了不同的篮板拍摄的部分，它不是一个镜头过的，它在剪接上有采用 focus 在背景那个北京房子啊、交通啊那些镜头，也有一些把它 focus 完全就放在篮板里面，而且它改变了很多很多篮板镜头，它改变它的 speed， 它有些时候放慢了，有些时候 speed up 了一点，让那个节奏跟随着那个音乐有它情绪上的变动。
Wonderful. All right. Well, thank you so much, Stanley Kwan, for joining us, and also Felix for helping out as well, and Professor Michael Berry for doing much of the translation, but also really a wonderful and insightful Q&A. Thank you so much.
Okay, thank you. Okay, thank you.
Thank you, everyone. 谢谢导演. Thank you, Stanley.
Bye now.